So hello students, so next topic is a logical equivalence in the mathematical logics. Okay, so equivalence means the similar things. Okay, means if the statement 1 is there and statement 2 is there, if you want to check that the two statements are equal or not, so that is called a equivalence basically. Okay, so here also we have some properties where we will get or we will analyze or we will check for the equivalence. Okay, so let's see here the compound proposition P and Q. Okay, so proposition P is there, proposition Q is there, and you are using some connectives in between P and Q. Okay, so that is called a compound proposition. Are said to be logically equivalent if PQ is a tautology. Okay, if PQ is a tautology. Now, what is mean by tautology? So you might be know about the truth table. Okay, so truth table in the last lecture we have seen, if the last column of the truth table is completely true, true, true and true, then you can say that this is a tautology statement. Okay, and what is this complete definition of logical equivalency? The compound statement P and Q are said to be logically equivalent if PQ is a tautology. Okay, so you need to check for the last column. So we will solve the some questions on how we can construct the truth table for the various mathematical logical logic statements. Okay, later on, first of all, see this. The notation PQ denotes that P and Q are logically equivalent. Okay, so see here, these are the property names and these are the some equivalence relations. Okay, so this is, first is identity law. So for and for or, there is an identity element. Okay, so what is that identity element and how we can check this is the identity element or not? Okay, so see here, P and T equivalence to P. Okay, so see here, whenever you want to check the any identity, check the first term and check the output term needs to be same. Okay, and you need to perform this AND operation with any of the element. Okay, and if you are getting P here and P here, then only you can say that this item is called the identity element. Okay, so for AND, T is the identity element. Okay, because you know for the AND, if anyone is false, then it is false. Okay, means if P is false, then you are getting false here. If P is true, then you are getting true here, because true and true, true you will get. Okay, whenever you are applying AND operation. Okay, that is that shows T is a identity element for AND operation or AND connective. Okay, next thing is P or F. Use P. Okay, so for checking identity, this first term and the result term needs to be same. Okay, and you need to perform the OR operation with any element. Okay, so what is that element? So that element needs to be F. F means false. Why? Because in the OR, if anyone is true, then it is true. Okay, so see here, if you replace P with the T, then you are getting T here. If you replace P with the F, F or F, you are getting F here. Okay, means F is the identity element for OR, T is the identity element for AND. Okay, I hope identity law is clear to you. Okay, then domination law. Okay, so you know dominate means what? Okay, means you are upper side, you are on higher side. Okay, so that is called a domination. Okay, see here, in the OR, T always dominate. Okay, as I already told you that in the OR operation or in the OR connectives, if anyone is T, then the result is T. Okay, so you need not to check the other elements. Okay, if the first element is T, then complete result is T. This is the rule for the OR operation. Okay, so see here, P or T, if you are doing, you are getting T here. So T is the dominating term for OR. Okay, means whenever you see T and the OR operation, you need not to check the other element, you directly put T in the result. Okay, for AND, F is the dominating element. Okay, why? Because if anyone is false, then it is false. This is the basically a definition for AND. Okay, so see here, P don't have in place, means P doesn't play any important role in this relation, because you will get F always. Why? Because F is there. Okay, and in AND, if anyone is F, then the result is F. You need not to check what is P. Okay, even if the P is true, then only you are getting false here. Even if P is false, then only you are getting false here. Okay, that's why F is the dominating term in terms of AND. Okay, next is double negation. Okay, so negation means, you know, taking a NOT means the negation. Okay, now see, double negation means negation of a negation. Okay, means F is true, then the negation of F, P is false, and negation of false is true. Okay, means double negation, you will get the same term. Okay, means P ka double negation le liya, to P hi aapko milega. Theek hai, maan lo P true hai, negation lene pe false ho jayega, false ka negation lene pe phir se true ho jayega, that is P. Okay, this is called a double negation. Now guys, next is Adam-Potent law. Okay, Adam-Potent law, see here, P or P use P. Okay, so this is the Adam-Potent law. So here in the or P always gives you P, because if this is true, this is true, then definitely in the or, if anyone is true, then it is true. Okay, if P is false, then this is also false, and if both are false, then you are getting false here in the or. Okay, in AND also, see here, P and P equivalence to P. Okay, so in the AND, okay, if both the P are true, then what you are getting here? True. Okay, if both the P, means P is false, then false and false will give you the false. Okay, you know AND. Okay, if anyone is false, then it is false. Here both the terms are false, then you are getting false here. If both the terms are true, then you are getting true here. Okay, next law is a commutative law. Okay, so commutative law is very easy. P or Q is equivalence to Q or P. Okay, so this is very easy. And P and Q is equivalence to Q and P. Okay, so this is called a commutative law. Okay, next is associative law. So which terms satisfies the associative law, that you need to check. Okay, here OR and both satisfies the associative law. Okay, so see here, P and Q in bracket OR R is equivalence to P OR in bracket Q OR R. Okay, so this is, both the statements are equivalent. Okay, even though you solve this bracket first and then took a OR operation with R, otherwise you solve this first and took a OR operation with P. Okay, so result is same. Okay, in AND also, P and Q is P and Q in bracket and R is equivalence to P and in bracket Q and R. Okay, so both the statements are true. So guys, you need to remember these properties: identity property, domination property, double negation, Adam-Potent law, then commutative property, and associative law. Okay, these are the very important laws. So guys, these are the also some laws which are give you the benefit whenever you try to simplify any numerical and all these things. Okay, so you can read these laws. Okay, distributive law, P or in bracket Q and R. So this is equals to P or Q and P or R. Okay, so this is called a distributive law, guys. Okay, P and Q or R. So P and Q you are getting, or P and R you are getting. Okay, so this is also very easy to understand, distributive law. Next is De Morgan's law. In the De Morgan's law, if you are doing P and Q negation, then this is equivalence to negation P or negation Q. See here you are having an AND operation and here you are having an OR operation. So De Morgan's law is P and Q, if you are taking a negation of P and Q, that is equivalence to negation of P or negation of Q. Okay, same with the or also, if you are taking a negation of P or Q, then you are getting that is equivalence to negation of P and negation of Q. Okay, so this is called a simple De Morgan's law. So guys, this is the very important whenever you solve or whenever you want to simplify any mathematical logical statement. Okay, whenever you want to create a truth table and your logical statement is very large. Okay, so in that case you can use these laws to simplify that expression. Okay, see here, absorption law. Okay, so absorption law is again a benefited for a simplification process. Okay, P or P and Q, it is equivalence to P. Okay, means whenever you see this term into the expression, you can directly replace this term with the P. Okay, or next thing, P and P or Q, then you can directly replace it with the P, because these two statements are logically equivalent. Okay, then next is negation law. Okay, inverse or complement. Okay, means you know the inverse. Okay, so you might be took some inverse of the matrix or inverse of the number. Okay, so you already know what is inverse. Okay, so 2 ka inverse agar main baat karu to minus 2 is the inverse of plus 2. Okay, like that P ka inverse kya hoga? Negation of P. Okay, so see here, P or negation of P, if you are doing, and this is the OR operation guys, in the OR anyone is the true. If anyone is true, then it is true. Okay, so if you are doing negation operation, or if you are doing the inverse, the means P OR operation with the P's inverse, then definitely you will get T, because either this is true or this is true. Okay, if this is false, this is true. If this is false, this is true. Okay, in AND also, if anyone is false, then it is false. Okay, so if P, this P is true, then this is false and you are getting false here. If this is true, then this is false and you are getting false here. Okay, this is called a inverse, or the you can call it as a complement. Okay, next is the equivalence law, guys. An equivalence law basically applied on the biconditional statements. Okay, so P double arrow Q, which is equivalence to P implies Q and Q implies P. Okay, see here, P implies Q and Q implies P. Actually, you need to remember, you need to write these formulas again and again, then only you will get this idea different about the different laws. Otherwise you will get confused with this formula. Okay, so there are many formulas, like 14th law we are studying here, so you will get confused. Okay, so you need to do a practice of this. Okay, next is implication law. Okay, so implication law says that P implies Q is the equivalent of negation of P or Q. Okay, so this is very simple implication law. Then biconditional property, P double arrow Q is equivalence to P or Q, sorry, this is AND, P and Q, or negation of P and negation of Q. So see here, P biconditional operator Q, it is equivalence to P and Q or operation negation of P and negation of Q. Okay. Next is contrapositive of the conditional statement. Guys, this is very important. Whenever we discuss about the proof techniques, in that case, we need to use this contrapositive statement. Okay, so P implies Q is equivalence to negation of Q implies negation of P. Okay, this is called a contrapositive. And we already seen in the contrapositive statement when we discuss about the implication statement. Okay, or the conditional statement. In the conditional statement, we already discussed about this property, contrapositive. Okay, so P implies Q is equivalence to negation of Q gives negation of P. Okay. Next, here you have an example. Okay, so solve this example. this is the P statement, this book is good, okay, and this is the Q statement, this book is costly, okay. Now you need to write the logical formulas for these statements, okay. So see here, this book is good and costly, okay. So how you can represent P and Q for this statement? This book is good and costly, guys, okay. So you need to do ending between P and Q. So P and Q you need to write. Okay, this book is not good but costly. Okay, so but ka means and, okay, and not good means you need to take a negation of P. Okay, so negation of P and Q. Okay, so see here I have the answer also. Okay, so see here, negation of P and Q. Okay, next is, this book is cheap but good. Okay, this book is cheap but good. Okay, so costly का निगेशन आता है चीप, ओके, एंड गुड गुड सेम ही है, ओके. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू नीड टू टेक अ निगेशन ऑफ क्यू, बट का मीनिंग होता है एंड देन गुड, ओके. सो निगेशन ऑफ क्यू एंड पी, ओके, यू नीड टू राइट निगेशन ऑफ क्यू एंड पी. दिस बुक इज नाइदर गुड नॉर कॉस्टली, ओके, मीन्स दिस इज नॉट गुड नॉट कॉस्टली, ओके. सो यू नीड टू यूज एंड ऑपरेशन अगेन, negation of P and negation of Q. Okay, see this. Okay, if this book is good, then it is costly, guys. If and then means this is the conditional statement, okay. So in the conditional statement we need to use implications, okay. So this book is Q good means P is, you need to use P directly, and it is costly, okay, means you need to use Q again. Okay, so P implies Q, you are getting here. Okay, like that you will get such kind of statement in the exam also, and you need to write the answers, how you can represent these statements into the logical forms. Okay, so in the next lecture we will see some more logical equivalence relation and how to construct the truth table and what is tautology, what is contradiction, this kind of things we learn in the next lecture. So thank you.